Now let's address a couple things. Because Trump's catching all kinds of heat today for a couple things. And actually, I'm going to defend him really on both things. You know, I'm fine with ripping on Trump when I feel it's necessary. No problem ripping on any of these people. I don't wear anyone's pajamas. Sometimes I feel like the criticism goes a little too far. I realize many people on the right, not all by any stretch, he's probably still the most popular Republican, but judging by what I see, I would guess half of the right seems like they're kind of sick of Trump, sick of some things. And so when you get sick of somebody, you tend to be a little bit harsher with your criticism than maybe is warranted. You've probably had this in your life with a girlfriend or a boyfriend or maybe even a spouse if you've gone through a couple divorces, haven't you? Where, look, it's not the end of the world if they leave their dishes in the sink and you're getting along great. Oh, we just had some great smoochy time. Didn't we have a lovely time at dinner last night? Oh, I can't wait to introduce you to my mother. Oh, you left a dish in the sink. Oh, no big deal, sweetheart. Let me get that for you. That's one situation. Another situation is you're just about sick and tired of his crap. And he forgot to take out the trash, and he's lazy, and there's no money coming in, and he's kind of a jerk sometimes, and he drinks too much, and soon it becomes a big deal when he leaves the dish in the sink. Now, no, it matters a lot. Now you're disrespectful and lazy, and this is just more proof, you know what I mean? When you get sick of somebody, people tend to nitpick a little too much. Look, we've all done it. It's happened to all of us, I myself included, not pointing fingers. I get it. And I realize there's some of that for Trump. So Trump goes on TV, Real America's Voice. Actually, used to work for that network. He goes on TV, Real America's Voice, and he's talking about these big evangelical pastors. A huge one here in Texas. His name is Robert Jeffress. I'm not for him or against him. I know nothing about him other than he runs some kind of a mega church here in Texas. I don't know. Good or bad, I don't know, nor do I care. But Trump last time enjoyed, I would argue, the bulk of the evangelical support from major pastors in the country, and he enjoyed that during the primary. Now, guys like Robert Jeffress have come out, and they've said things like this. They basically said they're going to wait and assess the field. That's what Jeffress said. They're going to watch the GOP field. They're going to wait. They're going to watch. They're going to see. And Trump, he called out what he says is disloyalty. This is Trump's quote. His quote is, quote, "That's a sign of disloyalty. There's great disloyalty in the world of politics, and that's a sign of disloyalty." Now, let's pause for a quick moment, because maybe you're doing what Chris is doing right now and rolling your eyes at that. Okay, let me defend Trump on this for a second. One, it's not a sign of disloyalty. In a vacuum, it's not a sign of disloyalty for you to wait and see. Make all these politicians, Trump included, go out in a primary and earn your vote. America in 2023 is not the same America we had 2 years ago, 4 years ago, 6 years ago. We have a different set of problems, a greater set of problems. So if you're doing the Jesse Kelly, I'm going to wait and watch and see. I might still vote for Trump in the primary. I might vote for Heavy D. I might vote for someone else. I don't know. If you're doing that, that's good. Make these people go earn your vote, all right? So it's not a sign of disloyalty. I'm not calling you disloyal. But remember this. We view everything that happens in life through our own personal perspective. And what is true for you may not actually feel true for me because I have a different perspective. You have a different perspective than I do on things. So much of life is a matter of perspective. You have a different one than I have. I have a different one than Chris has. Because of our own experiences, because of how we lived, our perspective is different. For example, I on occasion, I try not to make this often, but I on occasion will lose my temper with something around the house. Now, I'm not talking about at the kids or at the wife, but it'll be something. It's normally an inanimate object of some kind. I'll stub my toe on something. There'll be a stool or a table. I'm famous for stubbing my toe. I wear size 14 shoes, so my feet stick out all over the place like water skis. I stub my toe, and I will lose my temper when I stub my toe. That's probably not abnormal, but I do. And what has happened before in our house is I'll stub my toe, hurt myself, And while I'm there saying things, sorry, Lord, that I probably shouldn't say in front of the kids, the wife will get mad at me for how mad I am. And that in turn would make me mad. What is your problem? I stubbed my toe. I wasn't yelling at you. Well, she, because she was a gymnast, had coaches with bad tempers. And her perspective is a man freaking out, losing his temper, makes her uncomfortable, makes the whole house uncomfortable. And so from her perspective, I'm out of line when I do that. From my perspective, what's your freaking problem? It's my toe, not your toe. But you see how that's two totally different perspectives based on life experience? And I don't know that one is wrong and one is right. It's two different perspectives. Trump cites lack of loyalty. These evangelical pastors, they're going to wait and see. Lack of loyalty. This is what it's like from Trump's perspective. Before you kill him for that, this is what it's like from his perspective. From Trump's perspective, the 2020 election was his. He thinks he was an excellent president, and for the most part, he's right. He sucked it up during COVID, but for the most part, he was an excellent president. He feels that the 2020 election was stolen, that he should rightfully still be president, and that his nomination to be the GOP nominee should be a foregone conclusion because of those two things, which in Trump's mind are a fact. I was a good president. A, B, the election was stolen from me. So anybody considering throwing their support behind anyone else but me is a traitor, is disloyal. And when you add in this, Trump, now this is his own fault because Trump is maybe the worst chooser of personnel of any person I've ever seen on the planet. I don't know that I've ever seen a human being surround himself with more losers and idiots and traitors and grifters. Donald Trump is constantly being screwed over by people in his inner circle. Remember what his presidency was like? I used to lose my mind. You used to lose your mind because he'd hire some idiot. And of course, the idiot would last for a week. And then they'd quit and write a book just trashing Trump about what a piece of trash Trump was. And over and over and over again, he would get done wrong and done wrong and done wrong by people who worked for him. So much so that he kept Ivanka and Jared close to him when they're a couple card-carrying liberals who ruined his America First agenda, but he kept them close to him. Why? Because in his mind, at least they were loyal. At least they weren't going to screw him over. So Trump is the jilted lover at this point who's been done wrong by so many people who he thinks he helped. And he's not necessarily wrong. Hey, I need a Secretary of State. Oh, here's some idiot I know, Rex Tillerson. Hey, Rex, let's be here, you come be my Secretary of State. Now, Secretary of State's a really big deal. So he brings in this idiot, Rex Tillerson, who now has on his resume of life, on top of everything else, Secretary of State. In Trump's mind, wow, that guy's going to be loyal to me for life. That's awesome. Look at this. I just made him Secretary of State. Tillerson leaves. He lasts about 35 seconds before he's running to the media telling them all what a piece of trash Trump is. In Trump's jilted lover mind, so many people have done him wrong. The second you show that kind of disloyalty, you're a traitor. So I'm defending him on this.
Support the First TV today and get instant access to exclusive specials like Who is Ron DeSantis? The History of FBI Scandals and America's Worst Presidents. Visit thefirsttv.com/support or download the First TV app to become a supporter and start watching today.